Hi everyone, kamusta kayong lahat? I hope you're all doing great. Welcome ulit sa ating Traders Plus by Melvin Jason De Vera YouTube channel. And now, i-discuss natin ulit yung ating weekly market analysis. This time, we are going to cover not only the Forex pairs, also some stock indices like the Dow Jones and the DAX, plus some coins in Binance that ni-request din ng ating mga viewer and mga subscribers. Kaya kung kayo may mga request, please comment down below na maisama natin yan sa ating mga analysis. Okay, so let's start with our analysis with the US Dollar Currency Index. Alright, so looking at the chart of the US Dollar Currency Index, which is the DXY, kitang-kita natin dito na nagkaroon na ng trend reversal because of the breaching of the trendline resistance. Okay, so kahit dun sa daily mo muna tingnan ito. Okay, let's look at the one-day chart. There you go. So dito pa lang sa daily chart, makikita natin na nagkaroon na nga ng trend reversal evidenced by this candle right here, okay, piercing through the trendline resistance. So nagkaroon siya ng tinatawag na breaking of the trendline. Okay, breaking of the downtrend line. So this is now expected to continue moving up. Right. Now let's check at the H4. Dito, mas kitang-kita yung kanyang pagbasag. Okay? And from here also, makikita natin na meron na tayong support dito, right? This admin na support level here, which is a resistance on this part. And we can expect that it can be a resistance here as well. Right? Then we can see support right here. And also, of course, obviously here. So, paano kaya pwedeng maging galaw nito? Well, ganito. From what I'm looking at, pwede itong magpatuloy umakyat and then pull back, retest, no? Either dito, pwede rin mag-bounce or mag-continue dito and then magba-bounce. Likewise, pasok pa rin yan doon sa trend line. Okay? Ibig sabihin, it can bounce from the trend line. But overall, this means bullish pa rin ang aking bias for the dollar. So, what does it mean? I am expecting that this week, okay, US dollar will become stronger. Okay, so versus sa mga kaparis niya, I expect dollar to be stronger than the pairs. But of course, it depends also on the economies of the other countries. So, with that being said, let me bring you to the economic calendar and see natin kung ano ba yung mga kabang-abang. Okay. Alright, so looking at our economic calendar, no, the data, by the way, came from the tradingeconomics.com. Okay, so knowing na sa trading economics, what you only have are these hanggang the forecast. And it's up to me to analyze the difference, the impact expected, and to score such events, right? Until I create this. Yan. Ano ito? Yung matrix, right? Okay. So let's take a look at the matrix. Look at US dollar for the entire week, summarizing all the scores for the expected impact. Dollar is expected to be strong, straight for the one week, no? Now, also one with another perfect score, itong CAD, perfect week scores now for the week. So that's a summary also of what's gonna happen. Now, let's take note on Friday, by the way, one of the most awaited high impact news is the non-farm payroll, this one, which is expected to be released, no? The data will be released 8:30 p.m. Philippine time, okay, on Friday, May 7. So dito, because the difference is a higher non-farm payroll, difference between the forecast and the previous reported data, so we expect dollar to be strong. Kasi ang non-farm payroll is an employment data. So higher employment, definitely stronger economy. So we expect dollar to be strong. Now, take a good look at CAD or Canadian dollar. Also at the same time, meron siyang unemployment rate na i-release. And the data is that more people have no jobs, no, or lower employment bale. Kasi higher unemployment eh. So this is weaker for the CAD currency. Okay? So therefore, if you have weaker CAD and stronger dollar, Okay? And yung pair, USD CAD. Eh. So, base currency yung USD. Term currency yung CAD. So, strong base, weak term, you have to buy the pair. So, my NFP trade idea then here is a buy USD CAD. Which actually can also be swing trade idea. So when good for the week, no? Pwedeng mag-alaga ng pair na yon by USD CAD from Monday to Friday. Okay? Pwede niyo ang alagaan yon. But again, ha? As always, caveat, trade at your own risk. Okay? So now let's take a good look at our pairs, okay? Our favorite pairs. All right. So starting with the Euro USD. So kung titingnan natin nga, meron tayong trend line din ng Euro USD na binasag niya. Okay? So makikita natin dito sa ating chart, right? Na dinrawing ko rin yung trend line, no? So respetado ito eh dito. Yan. Okay? Respected 'yan. And then dito broken na. Okay? So what I'm expecting from this point, no? Andito yung price. Pwede itong mag pull back konti, right? It can pull back right here and then continue to move down, right? Challenged by this level. Pwede uli itong umakyat and then down. Okay, so basically what I am expecting here, bearish ako for the bias ko sa Euro USD. Okay, gawa nga rin ng strong kasi yung expectation natin kay ano, kay US dollar. But as again, this is quite in the middle of this range. So pwede pa ito munang mag-pull back kahit hanggang dito, pwede pa yung mag-pull back hanggang dyan. Okay? Worst case scenario, pwede pa umabot dito yan. Okay? But then eventually, babalik pababa yan. So, ang masaantayin na tahanapin ko rito ay sell setups for the week. Alright. So now, let's move on to the next pair. Alright, for the pound dollar or GBP USD or GU, so nakikita ko pareho rin ang bias ko sa Euro USD. Bearish din. However, dito, as again, watch out muna tayo dito sa level na to. Kasi makikita nyo na key level to. Ayan, no? Support. Support. Right? Okay? Resistance here. Resistance here. Then naging support ulit. Resistance. So, what can this be kaya dito? Challenge yan. Can bounce, no? Pero parang ganito ang pwedeng mangyari dyan. It can go back up there dahil nga key level. Pero, key level din to. Okay? So, it will just be more like a resistance zone as well. Yan. Na naging support dito, sa area to, resistance dito, right? Support here, and resistance doon. So, another strong level din yan. So, malamang to, pull back all the way there, and then it will go down. Even breaking this level, headed to that level. Okay? So more or less, mga hanggang dito, pwedeng bumaba yan. Okay, but as again, hindi yan agad-agad bababa. No? Pwedeng tumaas muna yan. Now, if i-break niya agad dito, then you can start shorting or start selling it. Kasi there's a breakdown. Okay? Or here's another idea. Okay? Let's say, hindi nga siya muna bumalik. Ang nangyari, bumagsak siya kaagad. Okay. So there are two ways to trade it. One, sell right away or wait for a pullback and wait for a confirmation tsaka ka mag-sell all the way there. Okay? So yan yung conservative way of trading the pullback. Okay? Pero ano yan, ha? Trade mo yung break pala. Trade the break. Tapos wait for a retest at tsaka mo ngayon i-enter yung trade mo. Alright. Now, let's take a look at the dollar yen. Okay? So, what am I expecting here? Dito talagang naging bullish si UJ. And this was expected last week. Right? Tama nga yung ano natin, idea rito eh. Because of this twister bottom, it held, no? It is really expected to move up. And right now, the uptrend is still holding. Okay. However, as again, retest yan ng level na yan. Okay? Currently, nandiyan yan. So, two scenarios. One, the UJ may pull back to this level and then go up again. Okay? Another scenario, it can break and head here or even head directly doon pa kaya. Or it can pull back after break, no? Retest this line and then go again upward. Okay? So pwede niyang i-retest yung line na ito after a breakout, right? Because again, that's a strong level right there. Okay? But this level should also come in play. So pagdating niyan dito, iba pwede mag-take profit na, no? And then you know, naka-buy position na and then wait for a pullback, re-enter upon confirmation sa kayuli. Okay? Kapag nag-break naman dito, he-head mo na yung TP mo banda doon. Dito na yung TP mo. Ang gagawin mo diyan, pwede yung stop loss mo ang ilagay mo rito sa area ng to. Okay, gagawin mo na siyang trail stop. Alright. So, yan po yung ating idea sa USD JPY. Now, let's take a look at the dollar franc or dollar Swiss. Okay. So, dito looking at the daily, this really is very interesting kasi makikita nyo kaagad yung bullish reversal. Alright? So, this candle here is a bullish reversal. Plus the fact na, na manipis lang yung pwedeng mong maging risk. Okay? So, you can actually set a stop loss like below this level here. Right? Or it can be up to this level lang. Yan. Now, let's take a look at the H4. There. Yan. So, pwede kang magkaroon ng entry right here. Right? So, let's say this will be your buy entry. Okay, you can set a buy limit right there. And then place a defensive stop loss to be safe mga dito banda. Okay, below 0.90250 o 9025. Then ang take profit mo banda dito. Okay, 0.91925. Pwede na yan. Okay? So again, you are basing this from the expectation na ito, resistance naman talaga na naging support dito sa area ng to. And resistance also on this area. Okay? Then your buy limit was a level wherein nag-serve as a resistance part here, support banda dito, and support here. Okay? So yung layo ng stop loss na yan na below this level is safe. Okay? Hindi agad tamaan. Mahirap kasi yung maliit nga yung loss mo, pero masyadong malapit. E tatamaan lang, so medyo sayang yung trade. Alright? So paano pwedeng maging galaw nito? Pwedeng mag-pullback muna ito, then mag-bounce. All the way to your take profit. Right? Now, it can also be, right here, nag-bounce konti, pwede yung bumaba, na? Mga hanggang sa level na yan, and then pwede pa rin bumalik yan. Okay, that's why the stop loss should be below this support level here. Okay? Can it go further? Well, pwede hanggang dito. Yan, this level here. Pwede pa yan. Okay? That's also a possibility. Right. So, let's take a look at the next pair. So, the Aussie dollar versus the United States dollar. Dito, wala akong maire-recommend mo ng position, no? Although tama tayo rito last week na magpo-pullback siya, you can review the video ha, nung last week analysis. Itong ito yung sinabi ko noon. Aakyat yan tapos bababa, which already happened. Okay? But right now, technically sideway yan. No? Diba? So, tapos this is also a good level here. A key level. No? Support. No? So, pwedeng ito ay mag-bounce up. Alright? But hesitant din ako ng konti. Kasi bakit? Una, malakas nga kasi yung US dollar this week. So, if that being said, tapos baka mahina yung gold this week, eh, alam naman natin na yung Australian dollar eh, correlated kay gold. Okay, so pwedeng kapirasong angat, baba, basag. Pwedeng ganon. Okay, so if I am going to find my trade here, hahanapin ko muna yung basag dito. Right. So, below there, okay, once it breaks, tsaka ako e-enter ng sell idea. So yan ay more or less a sell stop, right? And I'm going to set my take profit around this area here, 0.7609. Okay? So kung sakali, dito ako magte-take profit. Yan. Ayan, yung entry ko dito, lalagyan ko lang ng konti above here as my stop loss. Perhaps after this level here. Yan. Okay? Pwedeng stop loss ko na yun doon. Okay? Or up to this point. Pwede rin. Okay? Para medyo maganda pa rin yung risk-reward ratio. So dito banda yung mga stop loss area ko. Pero talagang ano, ideal stop loss doon. Yan. Yan ang talaga ideal stop loss dyan. Kaya lang ha, as again, medyo sobrang sobrang layo, no? Kung dito yung sell stop ha. So kung gusto mo na doon yung stop loss, ang antayin mo sa limit. Okay, so ano yung sa limit? Ganito. Antayin mo itong bumalik doon. Tapos pag na-reject, tsaka ka magse-sell. Okay, and then above this level here, yeah, mga 78,550 area, ito yung stop loss mo. Okay? And of course, pwede mo nang gamitin take profit to. Yung pinanggalingan. Okay? Pwede maging TP na yan. Okay. Now, knowing na pareho lang halos ang basa with AUD-USD and NZD-USD, therefore, sa NZD-USD, pareho rin yung idea. Okay? Wala mo ng executable trade. No? It's either you have to wait na bumaba pa to dito, okay? And then mabasag, tsaka ka mag-sell. Okay. Now, if this goes down here and bounces, do not buy right away. Remember na baka yun ay maging retest nitong level na yan. So ano yung mangyayari pagka naging retest yun? Upon reaching this level, babalik pa baba. So sell pa rin ang hahanapin ko. Okay? Kasi tingnan nyo, key level yan. Okay? Now, alternate scenario, pag ito umakyat right away, beware, hindi pa rin ako confident mag-sell. So unless aantay-antayin ko yan, no? The best level to sell is around here, no? So mga dito ang sell area ko. Tapos above there is my stop loss, probably above this level here. Yan. Okay? So, ito ang aking stop loss. SL area ko yan. Okay? And TP, pwede ka dito. Sa pinanggalingan din. Alright? So, advice lang, iwasan yung pagsabayin. Okay? Ang i-trade ang AUD-USD at NZD-USD, pumili lang kayo. Okay? Kasi you are doubling or dinodoble nyo ang risk exposure nyo doon sa AUD and sa NZD pagka pinagsabay nyo yan. Okay. So let's check on the next pair. USD CAD. Okay. So for the USD CAD, this is really a good formation for me na para rin bang trend reversal yan. So I will be more confident on the buy trade. Okay. And of course, below this level here is obviously will be your stop loss. And you have a good possible TP area. Okay? So, mangyayari, ito yung risk mo. You buy, this is your potential risk, right? Kahit nga mga ganyan lang. And then your reward could potentially be up there. Okay? Pwede na yun. Kasi tingnan nyo, ito na rin yung almost level na susundan mo. Yan. Yan. So, pwedeng TP area na yan. So that's my take on the USD CAD. Now let's take a look at the crazy pair, si GBP JPY, right? The dragon pair. So kung titingnan niyo dito, okay? Meron na tong resistance dito, no? And last week tama rin tayo nang inaasahan it will hit this level and it will go down. And currently it is going down and may expected to be continuing to go down. Okay? However, dahil nga baliw minsan gumalaw to, no? Baka respetuhin niya to, tong area to. Okay? Ibig sabihin, pwedeng ito ay mag-pullback and then bababa and then mag-continue. Okay? So, your selling entry points can be number one, no? Below this level here. Okay, so you can enter here like a sell stop, no, kung ipe-pending mo. Or you can have a sell limit. Okay? Sell limit dito sa area na to pag bumalik. Okay, so again, if it pulls back, sell limit. Okay? If it breaks, sell stop. Ay, sa limit mo, pwede kang mag-SL above dito. Okay? So you're going to take a look at this line right here. Okay, that can be an SL1. And above there can be your SL2. Above, yun, dun. Pwede mag-SL2 ka. Okay? Para naman sa entry mo dito, okay, pwedeng ito ang SL mo mismo. So, ito entry mo, right? Dito ang entry mo, ito SL mo. And ito TP mo. Okay? So, this will be your sell. This will be your loss. This will be your profit. Okay? Profit, entry ng sell, stop loss. Alright. So now, let's take a look at the Euro-JPY. So sa Euro-JPY, kita-kita rin na nagre-reverse to mula rito. Right? So it reached the top and then now is on a downtrend and which can continue to go down. Okay? But up to this level. Kasi kita naman na resistance yan dito, resistance yan, no? And then support dito. So makikita nyo yung break and retest na nangyari. Right? So idiretso ko lang to. Makikita niyo na it was broken here and then niretest, no? Pero tumuloy eh. Okay, so we have another level here. Yan. Tapos binasag ulit. No? So this can pull back all the way here and then reverse. Okay? But this can also pull back up there. No? Kasi kahit paano, meron din tayo nakikitang structure dito. Ayan. So baka mag-bounce yan dyan. But this is also a tough time, a tough line, I mean, to break. So probably, pwede rin bumaba rito yan or doon. Alright. Alternate scenario though, okay, check natin ang Fibonacci. From this point here, all the way there. Alright. So makikita natin na talagang the 61.8 is in this level. Okay? So that means the likelihood na magpapatuloy itong pababa rito, mataas. Okay? So you can actually enter a sell trade, no? Hit this as a TP, or you can actually set a buy limit order here. Pending. Pag na-hit, na triggered, place a stop loss below the 78.6. And then, kapag umakyat doon, TP. So, these are your alternate scenarios. Okay? Ganong katiba yung level na yan. So, 61.8 yan na FIB. Eh. Okay? Now, let's take a look at the next asset. Alright, another favorite trade. Si gold. Okay? So, what am I looking at here? Bearish ang gold for me. But again, medyo malikot to eh. May level to rito. Ito, no? Which pwede niya ibalik doon. Tapos pababa. And could actually break this level all the way there. Okay? Yun yung nakikita ko dyan. Considering also for the non-farm payroll, strong nga yung US dollar, then gold might react opposite the dollar eh. Okay? So, again, pwedeng ito umabot dito sa level na to. Okay? Pero bago mangyari yun, no? Again, meron muna tayong babantayan na level. Okay? Ano yon? Ito. Yan. makikita nyo kahit itong long week of this candle, no? A lower week of the candle, inabot sa baybalik, no? So, pwedeng mangyari, umabot nga dito yan and babalik. Okay? However, this is also a good level. So, mangyari, upon return dito, parang retest lang yan, no? And then, baba, basag. Okay? Yun yung basa ko dito. But of course, to be safe, your stop loss levels should be above the next strong levels. No? So, kung magsesell ka dito, okay? So, kung dito ang sell entry yung hanap mo, okay? Kung ito sell entry mo, mga lagpas doon ng SL mo o hanggang dito. But anyway, ang TP mo naman, nandito. Okay? Ito naman ang TP mo eh. Pero masyado itong malapit as TP, ha? Masyado malapit yan. So, mga dito. Okay? So, dito, pwedeng point of break, no? So, limbawa, bumasag nga siya dito sa level na yan. Then, tsaka ka mag-start ng sell. Pababa. Okay? Now, with that idea, pag dito ka pumasok ng sell, okay? So, kahunan mo lang ng konti itong ibabaw na yan. And then, doon na yung SL mo sa taas. Okay? Mga dito ka mag-SL banda. Yeah. Okay. And then, of course, your TP banda dito. Ito yung TP mo. Okay? So, that's for your gold trade idea. Okay. Alright, now let's take a good look at the Dow Jones Industrial Average, no, or the US 30 index. So dito pretty much sideways, okay? So makikita niyo naman dito na playing in the range lang, no? Yan. But towards the upside, no. Parang ang bias ko pa rin is towards the upside. Okay. Una, makikita natin na this candle formation is actually bullish, right? Plus suportado ng line na ito. Okay, suportado ng linyang yan. Okay. Therefore, the likelihood na mag-continue yan, paakyat, mas mataas kesa sa ito ay bumagsak. So, ito ay pwedeng mag-pull back ng konti, no? To retest this level or this level here, but it is expected to go up there. Yun ang idea dyan. Alright? The good thing here is if you're going to take that trade, no? Hanggang dito lang yung possible stop loss mo. Okay? Below this tweezer bottom here. And take a good look. Na yan din ay naging resistance zone dito. Support dito. Na? So, that's a good level. Wherein, na, the idea is, it can go even here and still continue to go up. Okay? So, if this will be your buy zone, no? Sabihin na lang natin ito na yan. Yung malapit na yan, buy zone mo yan. Ito yung TP area mo. Pero nandito stop loss mo dapat. Okay? Yan. That will be your stop loss below this level here. Okay? In that scenario, looking at your risk-reward ratio, ito lang yung risk mo from your buy towards the stop loss. And then from your buy towards your TP, that's a good risk reward ratio. Okay? So this is for the US 30 cash. Okay. Now let's take a look at the JER 30 or the DAX. So same reading ako or idea with the US 30. There's a tweezer bottom here. Okay? That indicates that this is a good support zone. All right? So, resistance siya rito and turn into a support. And here, nireject na rin yung candle na yon. Okay, so this is expected to possibly revisit this level and then go again up there. Alright? So, ideally, pwede ka rin mag-set na stop loss mga below nitong level na yan, which is still a good stop loss zone. Okay? Logical. Kasi inuwasan mo muna to. Meaning, if this continues to go down here, it will just be fine. Let the trade recover and possibly hit your TP. Okay? Kaya dapat yung stop loss mo, banda dito. right? And this will be a buy area for you. Then this is your take profit. Okay? There you go. Now, let's take a look at US oil. Okay? So, ito yung oil mini. No? Tinatrick ko yung mini para medyo maliitan lang yung mga exposure. Okay? But trading the oil standard contract is still okay. Now, the reading here is that meron itong binasag din dito na level. So, ito pwedeng mag-pull back konti, but it's more on the downside for me. Okay? So, I am inclined to the downside here. Okay? And this, the downside target is up to this level dahil yan, no? Key level yan, support. Support. So, malamang hanggang dito lang din yan babalik. Alright? And this is a resistance area. A resistance here. Support here. And a resistance there. Okay? So, of course, if you will enter a sell, okay, let's say dito ka magsisell, you have to take a look at this level here. Up here, no? Above that, that would be your stop loss dapat. Okay? So, banda dito ka dapat magsiset ng stop loss. And this will be your take profit area. Okay. So, yan yung ating sa US oil. Okay. Now, let's jump to cryptocurrencies. So, for the cryptocurrencies, we're going to take a look at the charts in Binance. Okay, powered by TradingView. Okay, so let me share the screen. Okay, so let's start with the Bitcoin. Okay, but again, ang magiging pair ko rito versus the USDT, no? The common used term currency or term crypto pang pambili ng other crypto. Okay, so I'm looking at the spot market though. Okay, so how do I analyze this? Makikita natin that Bitcoin had broken this trend line here. No? So again, this is a strong trend line. Okay, an uptrend and was broken here. And tama naman tayo na nagpatuloy nga itong bumaba here, right? But umakyat. So, and now nagpo-form na rin siya uli ng another tip here, which I can consider a rejection. No? Ito, rejection. So, what is clear here is pababa ito. Okay? And this can reach this level here kasi this is a resistance here, support here, right? Corner pa siya nung trend line, no? Tapos dito, ayan, no? Nag-reject siya nung lower week na yun, no? Then resistance here, support again here. So malamang dito pwedeng mag-bounce. Okay? So after reaching this point, Bitcoin may pull back and when it touches the trend line, pwede uli siyang bumaba. Unless basagin niya yung trend line, pero kailangan niya munang tawirin din itong resistance dito para matawag nga siya na talagang bullish na. Okay, so as soon as makatawid na rin dito, then it can be potentially going back to its 60 plus levels. Okay, so yun po yung basa ko sa BTC slash USDT o Bitcoin. So punta ngayon tayo sa Ethereum. Alright, so ETH o yung Ethereum ay nagrarally, no? So dito ang magandang tingnan natin kasi it's forming a new all-time highs, no? Kung how strong is the trend still, no? Meron pa bang momentum to? May strength pa ba yung uptrend, right? We cannot deny that it is really on an uptrend. Alright. So looking at the directional movement index, the ADX is from the 20, 21, now it's 26. So ibig sabihin moving up. This means palakas pa yung trend. Okay, it's at the low values increasing. Okay, so from 20 to 26, pag ito lalo na umakyat ng 40 yung ADX, ang lakas niyan. Okay. And the positive DI, which is the uptrend, is above the negative DI, which is the downtrend. So, ang prevailing trend is the uptrend. Now, let's take a look at the H4. Alright, so sa H4, there's a pullback that is going on. Makikita nyo na bumababa itong plus DI, umaakyat itong minus DI. Alright? But hindi pa naman sila nagkocross. And the ADX is at the high value. Although, yumuyo ko or nagpa-flat. Okay? So this can really pull back, Now, applying a Bollinger Band, ang tinitingnan ko, pwede itong umabot dito sa middle band. So, around 2.8. So, malamang ito, pu-pull back towards this, and then we'll go again up. Possibly breaking the high. Okay? And producing another all-time high. So, kung mag-aabang ka ng entry, buy pa rin ang entry mo, pero pwede mo pa-pullbackin mo muna, at least to the middle Bollinger. Alright? Now, pwede naman to be safe. When it reaches the middle Bollinger band, abang ka ng green candle na magko-close above the middle band para yun yung mas confirm ka na, okay, all the way up na ako. Okay? Otherwise, kung hindi nagkaroon ng gano'n na candle, abang ka dun sa lower band. Okay? And perhaps, lagyan mo na ng RSI sa baba para tingnan mo kung oversold ka na. And then, kapag two conditions met, no, RSI plus ito, okay? So, let's say, here's how you do it. So, kung maglalagay ka ng RSI, punta ka dito, okay? Type RSI, and then relative strength index. Okay? So, i-edit ko rin kulay nito para malinaw. Yan. So, sabihin, pwede ngang abangan mo yung candle mo na bumaba doon with your RSI going also down here. Okay? So, pagka nangyari na yon, condition 1, condition 2, then you can buy. Okay? Para pag-akyat nito, kasabay mo. Pag-akyat. Okay? So, that's another strategy for the ETH USD. Alright, now let's take a look at Dodge. No? Favorite doggy natin. So, ano ba nakikita ko dito? Well, MACD, bullish pa rin to. Okay, this is a daily chart. And candle formation-wise, this is more like a round bottom. Okay? Possibly, hanggang doon. Okay? And pwede niyang basagin yan. So, akyat, and pwede niyang makabasag. Alright. Now, another scenario is, pwedeng ito ay cup and handle, pero wala pa yung handle. So, ibig sabihin, huwag ka mong matataranta kung halimbawa, from here, no? Form yan dyan, tapos hindi nag-break, no? Hindi nag-break dito. Anong nangyari? Babalik, tapos mag-form ng ganon. Okay? So, ito yung tinatawag natin sa candle formation natin, technical analysis, na cup and handle. Yan, tasa, hawakan. Okay? And again, this is a bullish idea. So, malamang yan, magko-continue pa yan to move upward. Alright. Okay. So, let's take a look at the next coin. So, we have the V-chain, right? Or si VET. Okay, bet nyo ba to? So, since nakikita ko rito, no, the moving average, so I have two types of moving average. Pareho lang namang maiksi. EMA 9 and EMA 20. Okay? Para medyo may dynamism, no? May dynamics. And makikita natin, bullish yan. Why? Because the faster moving MA, which is the EMA 9, okay, is above the EMA 20. Okay? And the price is above it. So ito yung ating tinatawag na alignment of the stars. Okay? So ano yun? Your price, okay? So let's write it down. So your price is above, no, the EMA 9. Okay? And EMA 9 is above EMA 20. Alright. So that's a bullish alignment. Okay? So hanggang saan kaya pwede itong umakyat? Ganun. Well, taking a good look here, hanapin natin yung mga key level. Well, of course, we have here a resistance. Ta-da! No? So yun. Pwedeng umakyat to dito, possibly pulling back and breaking it. Okay? So, anong idea doon? Possible round bottom. Okay? Or possible cup and handle. Pero possible lang, kasi hindi pa form eh. So, ayan, no? Baka umabot doon, no? Magbabalik dito, and then form another. So, yan, cup and handle na yan. Then, aakyat yan, pagka gano'n. Okay? So that's my reading on VET or V-chain. All right, now let's take a look at the sweet coin, no? Si cake. Okay. So dito sa cake, no, okay, sa sweet tuloy. Sa cake, no, nagkaroon ng pullback. Okay? So nakailang beses to na nag all-time high makikita nyo. And then nagpo-pull back. So what I'm thinking here is buying pa rin ako pero on the dip. And this, no, being completed right now on the 4-hour chart, right? Oh, ayan, so 4-hour chart ako. Na-complete yung ano yo, yung pair, no? So this is bullish for me. Yung magkatabing candle na yan. Okay? So it's a good time actually to enter and then it can move up. Okay? It can resume going up. Now, if that fails to go up, pwede pa yung bumaba, pero ang nakikita kong magandang area na yan ay itong 38.2 retracement level of the Fibonacci. So which means it can go down there and eventually go up. All the way back up there. No? So strong buy pa rin ako dito. All right? So either you buy right now, okay? Or you wait for it to revisit the 0.382 Fib and that's where you might enter. Okay? So heading to our last crypto to take a good look at. Okay. So, obviously dito, napaka-kaunti nung candle, I cannot really get a strong analysis, but now I am more onto the upside for bake. Okay, so this is bake. Kung merong cake, may bake. Okay, so ibine-bake yung cake. No, just kidding. So, makikita nyo dito, when it started flat, it bullishly risen, no, tumaas. Then, meron tayo parang flag and pole, no? So let me emphasize that. There you go. So kapag meron tayong flag and pole, okay? O flag and pennant. So ito yung ating flag, right? So let me draw the flag. The flag is more like this. You can actually take that and this. Yan. So this is your flag. Right. Now, where's the pole? Ito yung pole from here and that candle here. There. Now, the idea, usually, kapag may flag and pennant or flag and pole, is imu-move mo yung height ng pole patong mo sa flag kahit dito mo na lang ipatong. Therefore, ito yung pwedeng maging TP mo. Okay? So, your target can be up to this level here. Yan. So saan mo na iisip to na pupunta? Doon. Mga $8.68. Alright? It can pull back. Okay, huwag matakot. Then, balik. That's a possibility. Right? However, if it broke this level, cut. Kung mga naka-buy position, ha? Cut. Kasi baka dito ka bumalik. Malalim yan. Okay, halos mauubos na yung ano mo. Kung lalo na kung kababay mo lang, no? Alright? Dito ka nagbabay, eh. Oo. So, hanggang dito ka lang magka-cut loss. Hanggang dito ka lang. Okay? Beyond that, wala na. Huwag ka nang mag-hold ng buy. But, there's a still good upside right there. Okay? So, I hope this had been informative, no? Sa inyo. Okay. So, now we're done with covering our favorite currency pairs, no? The indices and the cryptos that you had requested. All right. So if you want to learn more about the other instruments that you want to cover in the analysis, again, comment down below. Please also, no, give this a thumbs up. I-like nyo naman yung channel, pati yung mga videos, no? Then i-subscribe, mag-subscribe din kayo. All right. And see you every week sa ating weekly market analysis. Happy trading, everyone. God bless.